Hello and welcome to the EMP Tech Group. Backup Series in the support area, Backup Series with Chris Compton. Chris, you've been here over 18 years. I called you a heavy hitter in an email to a customer today. All these mobile computers, all these hand scanners, fixed scanners, things like that. You are supporting customers with this all day. You're running projects, you're doing MCL programming, you wear a lot of hats, and including internal training. And a few weeks ago, you did some training for us as a group where you showed us the OCR capabilities of Zebra products. And that goes from scanners, right? Handheld scanners. You've got a ring scanner right there, mobile computers, and even the fixed scanners. And I'll talk about fixed scanners and then I'll move my way backwards. So fixed scanners have incredible OCR capability. They have AI baked in. You can train them and they'll just bang. They'll just grab. They'll read a whole label, all the text, you know, pretty well out of the box really quickly. You can get this set up. Yep. But what we had a customer who had a project and they needed to read just three characters off of a label. And we started kind of scrambling, trying to find the right product to get it done. And I realized that the ring scanners, the hand scanners, particularly those, have got some OCR capabilities I didn't know they had. Right. And mobile computers with data wedge have got some incredible OCR capabilities. So we decided to do some internal training to make sure everybody's knowledge base was up to date. And then we thought we would train the rest of the world on that as well.
Yeah.
One thing before we dive in. OCR, optical character recognition, which is reading characters in addition to barcodes. So this scanner can read a barcode, but it can also be trained to read characters.
Correct.
Then there's OCR font, and that's a font specifically made for this kind of reading, which is better. The hand scanners, the ring scanners work mostly with the OCR font. You'll start getting substitution errors. The mobile computers can read probably both.
Yeah, the mobile computers will read all. They're using AI now too.
Yeah.
So even in our demo, if you remember, I was reading off of a can.
Yeah.
So as long as the font has some type of, you know, pretty distinguishable characteristics, it can read.
Got it. The Mac Daddy is the fixed scanners. They'll really read. You could do about anything with them. So then we're going to go backwards. You're going to show us what the ring scanners, hand scanners, how you configure those, what the settings in 123 scan, which is the configuration software for the Zebra handheld scanners. Show us how that works.
Yeah, so the ring scanners and hand scanners all are using templates. So you can justify making multiple templates or one template. So if you wanted to read something, let's say that's 10 digits, but it's alphanumeric, then you might write it to where it's only reading alphanumeric. You can say, if you know the first digit's always a letter, you can distinguish that and then say, I want the first four to be letters, let's say, and then the next six.
To make sure you're reading the right field, to make sure that you're getting the right data interpreted.
Right.
That first is always a letter, so it can't be a zero. It's got to be an O, things like that.
Yeah. So you can design it like that, right? You can create that. This is all done in 123 scan under their templates. So if you go to their general settings, there's an OCR field. And then if you scroll down here, you have OCR templates. So that's essentially, like you said, that we can grab those templates. What we did find is that, like you said, OCRA and OCRB is really what they're designed for. There are some things like travel documents and passports and driver's license and those type of things where they already have it pre-built in. So you basically select it and it's done.
So I have driver's license and I'm looking at the front and I scan that front. I can get all the data on that driver's license, not the back, the barcode, but the front with just the text.
Yep.
Because it knows where everything is. It knows the format. It's got the OCR characters.
Right.
All that.
Exactly. Because they're all built in OCR. But for instance, just for like a demonstration, I designed this to read something between 4 and 10 characters.
Okay.
So if I come over here and pull the trigger, as you'll see, it is quite snappy.
Wow.
I mean,
with the OCR characters, it's getting them right away.
Yeah.
And that's the low-end ring scanner. That's Zebra News RS2100.
Yes.
Really inexpensive ring scanner. I mean, it's a few hundred dollars. It's not that much money.
Right. But we did find one thing. We found that the longer-range scanners do not do a good job at all. We tried using the way more expensive units, and they don't really work. because they're
trying to read a barcode 60 feet away. Yeah.
Correct, 40, 20 feet away. So we did find that it was fairly hard to use those, but anything short range, we found really good success.
Works with OCR really well. Yeah. So same with the hand scanner, the
DS3608.
By the way, it could be a 3678. It could be Bluetooth.
Yeah.
Doesn't really matter.
And this one, we did something different. Because we're starting to deal with AI and stuff, especially with the mobile computers and their Zebra's considering OCR, the barcode, and the text. So okay. In this specific case, I kind of just designed it so people could kind of see. This is a multi-barcode read. So if you see all the barcodes on here, I can scan it. And I just read whatever fields I actually wanted to read.
Okay.
Now, where this is important is to figure that out right, you need prefixes. That's why using industry standards is super important, because all of those GS1 codes, all those type of things have a prefix that we can identify, obviously, and then
let me spit this back. So you've configured the scanner that this field is the one you want.
Yes.
But the good news is you can just aim anywhere at the label.
Correct.
It'll find that, it'll decode it. Mm-hmm. And you sort of mentioned this, multi-scan's an option as well.
Yeah.
To where if you wanted to read this field and that field, you could go read them both.
Yeah, that's what I did.
Okay, so you read two fields. Okay.
I read 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fields.
Five fields, and you put them in the right order. So
correct.
It doesn't like spit them out any order.
Nope, yeah. Now you go right into the 1, 2, 3 scan, and when you're designing multi-scan, you tell it what order you want it.
Okay, so a little off the OCR path, but that's great. That's exactly what we wanted to see.
Yep.
Okay, what's
we have
next?
Money.
Oh, wow,
so
nice.
There is a specific font for money, so it will read
make it look
serial
hard.
Number. I know, it was easy earlier.
Will the ring scanner wear it?
Probably not right this second.
Okay.
But it was...
Ah, that's all right. We're not going to reshoot the whole video for that.
Yeah.
So you can, and I'm going to show this.
Yeah.
So the serial numbers on the bill are specifically set up, and if
yep.
you get the scanner configured right, you'd be able to read the serial numbers.
Yeah, I was reading it earlier before
okay.
you came up. I blame it on standard video technical
okay.
difficulties.
All right, so we're gonna transition. Let's talk about it.
Yeah.
So this is a DS909908,
yep.
so just a convenience store scanner, but it's also capable of OCR.
Yep.
Like a DS2208. What about Zebra's low end scanners?
22s do not have.
They do not.
Those
so you do have to spend up and get the $500 scanner, not the $300
right.
scanner. But you don't buy the $1,000 scanner. You can
correct.
Yeah, you could do a lower end one.
Yep.
And the higher end ring scanners, as long as they're not long range. One thing we did find out, Zebra's got that little small WS50.
Yep.
That's a ring scanner with a little mini terminal on it.
Yep.
It doesn't work with those
no.
either.
No, that was actually obviously from the project. We
yeah.
found that they didn't put the
customer
software
already
in.
Had one of those. We were trying to get that to work.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, now we're going to shift over to mobile computers. And I'll just lay some groundwork. Mobile computers from Zebra all have something called Data Wedge. It's super powerful barcode scanning application that Zebra's written for the Android device.
Correct.
And we typically use it to go, hey, I want to scan that barcode, and it's got to go into a field on the screen in the application.
Correct.
So it just kind of runs in the background. Also capable of OCR though, right?
Yeah, full yeah. OCR and multi-scan and full document scan. So it can scan a full document, pull in OCR and barcode elements that you're wanting. It can actually even check for a picture if you wanted to do that. Some capabilities, what we learned is that they're all API based. So
okay.
you need to write a program or have some type of web extension that can pull that API from the device.
Okay.
So maybe using like an enterprise browser or something like that. Other things like just standard OCR, as you can see, I have turned on here. If I go into this OCR as I go over something, you'll see it actually pull. And then I can
they read,
tell it to capture. And in this instance, of course, you know, I
there
moved
go.
It. And there you go.
Okay.
So it knew that was D-item.
And that's not OCR font. That's
not
just
OCR
a regular
font.
That's
a stand aerial font.
So the Data Wedge product does a better job at non-OCR fonts.
Correct. It's using AI, much like the fixed reader.
Okay.
There's an actual AI element.
Okay, great.
There. Yeah.
I'll say it again. 5 years ago, it'd be like, yeah, if a customer asked me about this, I go, yeah, they won't do that. Now it will.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, the mobile computers for sure. And this is all newer. Most of this was added in Data Wedge 15 or newer.
Okay.
So
very nice.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, an obscure part of Zebra's product line, right?
Yeah.
And it's why we constantly have to, we do these trainings once a month internally just to stay up on all this. And it's funny because as always, a lot of times the case, the customer comes to us and goes, hey, I need to do this. And we're like, okay. We immediately come up, us sales reps come upstairs to you guys and go, what can it do? And you already had a lot of knowledge on what it was capable of and what it wasn't. Yeah. So if you need, go ahead.
We have the fixed reader. Did you want to see that?
Sure.
Yeah. So in preparation of this, I went in.
Look at you.
And designed a label. So what I did is I designed it off this label and fixtured it off of this text.
Okay.
And as you can see, it's passing up here. And you can see what text it's reading. So I'm literally reading the full shipping address out of it.
Oh, nice.
I'm reading this barcode down here out of it. And then just pulling this to fixture it. So now if I rotate it, pulls the same data and passes.
Let's talk about that, because this is kind of machine vision language is what you're saying.
Yeah.
You pick a spot on the label that we always know there's this there, right? And so that's our anchor.
Yep.
And then we can find other things on the label. So as you're showing, no matter which way you turn it, if it's cockeyed, if it's whatever, you'll know where to look because you're anchored on that. You're not reading the spot in the green brackets. You're just using that as a fixture.
No, you could theoretically fixture and read from it, obviously, but no, you don't have to. You can even use, we haven't tested it yet, but in the newest firmware or software, you can use fixturing barcodes even. So you could actually use the barcode to read it, fixture it, and then read off other OCR.
And find other things that you know on the label.
Exactly.
Based on
so
what
if you had a specific barcode that was always there or something, you could
use that. A lot of times we'd use a logo or something that was always on there to anchor off of and then look on the label for other things.
Yeah, and that's obviously the easiest way. But it is super useful, and this is using just a barcode reader. So this is emulating the FS42 with the OCR, you know, added to it.
Well,
so this isn't a vision system.
Right, because that gets really expensive.
That gets much more
expensive. So, I mean, these are expensive enough, but for a fixed scanner. Okay, so let's talk real quick. Using these in like a packout station is a big thing. You put it overhead and you just, the trade shows, they show people throwing a Frisbee underneath of these with a barcode because you could read it. Or in this case, OCR. So having something like this where you are trying to read text and you're trying to put it under there, snap the text really quick and then pack it out or something like that is the case. And the customer who is wanting to do the OCR, this is one of our recommendations to them. Their workflow wasn't good for bringing the product to a fixed camera. They wanted to use the ring scanner.
Right.
But so that would be the answer because we found they're capable. So good stuff. All right, I'm going to cut you off. You got more? You really prepared for this one.
No, I think we're good. We went over the hand scanners and their OCR capabilities, the mobile computers, and then the fixed reader.
Cool. Well, this deep dive on the product and what it's capable of is what we're doing, what guys like Chris and the whole team upstairs here are doing all the time. So we'll put you guys to work for you guys if you reach out to us, emptechgroup.com. Always the best place to reach us. Thanks for your time.